and I work in quality control and on the farm here at Meadowbrooke Gourds. Today I'm going to show you a couple ways to help get your gourd ready to craft. First thing I'm going to show you today is how to re-stem your gourd. A lot of people like to have stems on their gourds while they do their crafting, but they can fall off during the washing or drying process. Before you start drilling your gourd, you're going to want to have your safety glasses on and your mask. When you drill your hole, you're going to want to make sure that you stop a couple times and just make sure your hole is not too loose for your stem. Whenever you're putting your stem in, you're going to want to make sure you put it in and that's a snug fit and you'll twist it. We use Loctite glue, which is like super glue, for our stems, and we dip the end of the stem into the glue and twist them in. You can also use tacky glue, or you can also put the glue directly into the hole and then put the stem in. When crafting a smaller gourd that you might want to hang, we use paper wrapped wire as our stems. You can get it at any craft store. To drill the hole, we use a 1/8 tapered bit. And again, you can use any glue that you'd like. If you ever have extra glue, just wipe it off. The tacky glue does dry clear, and you're going to push the stem into the glue and just twist it. With this stem, you can bend it or you can twist the top like we do a lot of times. Before crafting, you'll want to make sure that any glue that you're using is dry. We use the wood filler here at Meadowbrooke Gourds whenever we are keeping the gourd natural, because the wood filler blends in better. Here we use golden oak. To fill the hole, squeeze the wood filler right into the hole. Whenever you have extra, you're just going to wipe it off. You can also push some of this in with your finger if you need to. And it will take a couple minutes for this to dry. If you're going to use dye, stain, or paint, we suggest using white spackling. The dyes and stains blend onto the gourd and make it less noticeable than the wood filler. This is an example of a stress crack. This is a really bad one. What you're going to do is put the spackling right onto your finger and you're going to push it right into the crack to fill it. And then you're going to need to wipe off all the excess around the sides. If you do leave the excess on there, it will get stuck in your paint and dyes and you will notice it. Once your crack is smooth, your gourd is ready to be crafted. If you have any questions about how to repair your gourd before crafting, please call us at 717-776-3470 or email us at sales@mbgourds.com.